How should I back up a new machine? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is an interesting problem when you get a new machine. Here's the question I got. I'm supposed to receive a new laptop tomorrow and don't quite understand how to make your suggested system image backup before connecting to the internet without connecting to get the software. Can I download it to an external drive and then run software directly onto the new machine? Offline? This is almost a chicken and egg situation. In order to back up the machine, you want to download the software, but that modifies the machine that you're trying to back up. There are a couple of approaches to this that range from pedantic to pragmatic. And as you can imagine, I tend to favor the pragmatic approach. The goal is what we would call a pristine backup. In other words, a backup with ideally no changes whatsoever made to that hard drive in that new machine. That way you have an image literally of the factory condition of that hard drive. The problem, of course, is as soon as you turn the machine on, the system starts making changes. It boots into Windows and starts the setup process and starts making changes to the very thing you didn't want to have changed. And we can get a pristine backup, but ultimately, I tend to favor the pragmatic approach. Turn on the machine, let it boot, complete the initial setup, including going online. As soon as that process completes, then download your backup software, install your backup software, and take a backup image of your machine. Nope, it's not pristine. Right? You've made changes to the machine. You've set up your account. You've installed the software. But from a very pragmatic perspective, honestly, that's good enough. Chances are you're not going to need this anyway. This is a safety net. But if you do, you've got a backup that is as close as is reasonably possible to the hard disk when it arrived. Now, another approach is what I call pragmatic but disconnected. As you're going through setup, because you are going to turn the machine on and you are going to set it up, don't specify your Wi-Fi. Not yet. You can do that later. That way, your machine will actually get set up and start running, but it will not reach out to the internet and it will not install anything other than what was already on the machine. Now, on a second machine, download your backup software's installer. Copy that to a thumb drive or some other drive that allows you to then take it to your new machine, install your backup software, and then take an image backup. It is, in theory, a little bit closer to pristine. It is not pristine. You'll have set up an account, you'll have, you know, logged in and that kind of stuff, but it will not have taken any updates. What if you really want the pedantic, not a single bit changed solution? Well, there are two approaches. One is, again, on your second machine, install the backup software this time, and then have that backup software create rescue or emergency media. Most of these drives will also allow you to take a backup. So what you do is you take this newly created emergency disk, you go to your new machine, and you very, very carefully configure it to boot from USB first. If you can boot from this rescue drive first, then your backup software can create an image backup of the main drive in the machine without anything ever having changed on that drive. Then when that backup is finished, you can boot from your hard drive normally and continue setting up the machine. But that theoretically would get you a bit-for-bit identical copy of your hard disk as it arrived on your doorstep before you did a thing. There's another solution that I consider to be pedantic overkill, and that is simply this. Remove the drive from your new machine. Connect it to your second machine that has your backup software already installed, and then take an image backup of it. You will not have booted from it. You will not have made any changes to it. It'll be an external drive as far as that other machine is concerned, and you could take an image backup. That's another approach that would get you the pedantic bit-for-bit image of your new drive. What do I recommend? I recommend you back up. Seriously, I recommend you back up as soon as you can, but I don't think you have to go overboard. Chances are you'll never need it. There's a really good chance that your machine will just continue to run. You'll deal with things as they come. If you do end up restoring to backups, you'll want something a little bit more recent anyway. You'll never really need to restore the entire machine to this factory initial condition. Soon enough is good enough. For comments, for updates, for links related to this and more, visit askleo.com/154141. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.